I'm going to demonstrate for chemical equilibrium how the equilibrium shifts for a gas phase reaction, namely nitrogen plus hydrogen to make ammonia, as we change temperature, pressure, or by adding moles of one of the reactants or products. And we'll use LeChatelier's principle to predict the direction where reaction will take place, which direction the reaction will change. And then I'll use an interactive simulation to show the actual numbers and behavior. Of course, we can always do the calculation, which says the equilibrium constant equal to the mole fraction of ammonia squared, the mole fraction of nitrogen, first power, the mole fraction of hydrogen cubed, and the pressure squared, where the equilibrium constant only changes as we change the temperature. So this, we can get the values, and that's what we'll use in this simulation. And this, we're assuming ideal gases, and that's an approximation which gets worse as we go to higher pressures, but to demonstrate behavior, we'll use ideal gases even at the high pressure. So the simulation is available on the Wolfram Demonstration Project site. You can search under chemical equilibrium to find it, and here's the location. So let's look at this simulation. So we're going to use essentially a bar graph to represent the amount of each component, and we also have the numbers listed. So what I'm starting out with is, if I added 1 mole of ammonia to my system, let it go to equilibrium at 150 bar pressure and 500 Kelvin, here is the distribution of nitrogen, hydrogen, and ammonia. And you notice mostly ammonia. Indeed, this reaction is run at high pressures so that the equilibrium concentration of ammonia is high. Let's look at temperature first. If I were to raise the temperature, if we were to predict by LeChatelier's principle, we need to know something about the reaction. Well, this reaction's exothermic, so then we should be able to predict, as I raise the temperature for an exothermic reaction, the equilibrium conversion is going to decrease. In other words, the amount of ammonia should go down as I raise the temperature, and indeed, you notice that's what's happening. So as I lower the temperature, I get more ammonia, almost complete. The numbers are not zero, but just to the significant figure. So let's go back to a value where we have both of these. So let's look at pressure. If we want to predict the direction of reaction as a function of changing the pressure, well, we could go back and look at our equilibrium expression. And this says, as we raise the pressure, since K is a constant, as we raise the pressure, we must increase the mole fraction of ammonia to have the same equilibrium value. And so as we raise the pressure, you'll notice we're making more and more ammonia. And maybe I should do this at high temperature to make it easier to see. So now as they raise the pressure, you can see we're making more ammonia and less nitrogen, hydrogen. Again, what we would predict from LeChatelier's principle. So let's go back to values. And let's look at if we add moles of ammonia to the system. Well, LeChatelier's principle says we add something to the right side, namely ammonia, we would shift the reaction to the left. And so we expect to make more nitrogen and hydrogen. So if I add ammonia, indeed, of course, I have more ammonia, but I'm making more nitrogen and hydrogen. So all the ammonia that I add does not stay as ammonia, but some of it reacts to nitrogen and hydrogen. Suppose we add hydrogen to the system, we expect the reaction to shift to the right, again from LeChatelier's principle. So if I add hydrogen, notice that the amount of ammonia increases, but now I've reacted not all the nitrogen, just it's too small to see on this scale. Likewise, if I add nitrogen, I expect the reaction to shift to the right. Indeed, adding nitrogen, notice the hydrogen decreases and the ammonia increases. So LeChatelier's principle predicts the behavior that we see, and the actual calculations allow us to get these numbers. And so we can use this simulation to quickly visualize the behavior that we expect to see.